Go ahead. Yeah, you're good. Go.
Once you find the acceleration, you can use it to find other elements such as time, distance, and average velocity. Instantaneous velocity is force and mass.
Different velocities. Acceleration can be found using different types of velocities. Average velocity. Average velocity is the total of different velocities divided by the number of velocities. An equation to find average velocity. So this is a velocity versus time graph. The straight line means it's accelerating, and velocity and time are directly proportional. So if velocity increases, the time is going to increase, or if the velocity decreases, the time is going to decrease.
Curved lines like these or that, it means that it is accelerating. The steepness of the slope shows an increase or decrease in speed as the time passes. Steeper as time passes, increase, not as steep as time passes.
Wait, can you go back to the slide really quickly?
So, there are different labels. So, this one's velocity versus time, that's why I think it's straight.
Okay.
And the other one's position versus time, that's why I think it's
But, like, time doesn't decrease.
Not decrease, but, like, they're just. So it'd be like if you're going like it's like it's proportional, but on here it's still like
I mean time goes on.
Yeah,
time goes on, it's not like
yeah. When a car speeds up and is going forward. Is going forward, or if the car slows down, it's going backward, it has a positive acceleration. So if you're doing like two negatives and two positives, it's going to be positive. It's like the same. So, when a car slows down, it's going forward, or if the car speeds up and going backward, it has a negative acceleration. Because it's two different signs in time, so it's going to be negative.
So here are some examples.
What is free fall? An object moving on the direction of the gravitational force only if free fall. The elapsed time is the time that has passed since the motion began. Gravity is a special acceleration in the only force acting on the object. So the acceleration is negative 10 meters per second squared. Gravity equals weight acceleration to gravity. So they're the same. And that's an example of free fall.
object accelerates at negative 10 meters per second squared per mile when it passes. So, for example, a 1 kilogram stone and a 10 kilogram cannonball, if you're falling with both accelerate at 10 meters per second squared per mile when it passes. So, here, these are from the textbook.
So, it just shows you the math of it all. So, these ones have different.
Sound.
I mean, you could see it, like in the previous picture you saw it from this.
Yeah.
So if this is 0, this is 10, like 1 second, and this is 20. I mean, this is 2, so negative 20. So, I mean, yeah, like that's just like
okay,
what the
yeah,
problem
have
is.
That right. Yeah.
So
a ball speeds up from 2 meters per second to 6 meters per second in 2 seconds. What is its
thank you.
average velocity during the pre-second period, which is a target, and how long was it?
On that page.
What is the average?